Muhammad from the US, he says, I was born and raised in Bangladesh and traveled to the US for a better job. And now I'm residing there. Maybe he got the green card. Maybe he got citizenship. But it's not a Muslim country. He cannot pray Jumu'ah on time. He cannot pray normal prayers at ease in the masjid because it's a kafir country. So will he be accountable on the day of judgment for doing such a thing? I don't know. Migrating to a kafir country is not permissible. The suffering that the Muslims face in such kafir countries is great. They are prosecuting them softly in the media, accusing them of terrorism, accusing them of extremism. They want them to leave all of their beliefs and conviction and follow their kafir way. All over the country, all over Europe, take off your hijab, shave your beard. You're not allowed to pray in the masjid. And if you pray in the masjid, there are rules. And if we don't like you, we're going to close your masjid. And we're going to accuse you of extremism and defying the unity of the country. I am a citizen of that country. I'm like you. There's nothing different between me and you. Same ID card, the same upbringing. The only difference is that I'm a Muslim and you're not a Muslim. Well, tough luck. You have to follow the way of our life. This is a tyrant way of doing it. A dictatorship way of doing it. I have my convictions. I have my religion. What do you mean I have to leave? Where is the freedom of religion? So they're forcing, they're shoving their way down our throats. They don't want you to be a Muslim. You want to be a Muslim? You have to drink wine, eat pork, leave your prayer. It's a must that you shake hands with the opposite gender. Why would I? It's against my religion. Well, then this means you're an extremist. Okay, if I want to go a little bit further and kiss on the cheek and maybe hug and maybe do something else. Oh, no. This is inappropriate. Why? Why shaking hands is appropriate and not the whole nine yards? This is awkward. This is weird. But this is the disbeliever's way of dealing with the Muslims. And the Muslims, they went to them. So you left your Muslim country. You went there. Okay, you go there for some time to gain money, start a business, and go back to your country. No problem. But to settle and live there, and you let your children grow as Americans and live the American way and probably end up doing drugs or LGBTQ and refusing Islam. And then you ask, will Allah hold us accountable? Of course. So I can't answer your question specifically for your case, but if you have the ability to go back home and live among the Muslims, you have to do that.